of Limerick. We're on Hunky Dory's fight night. Our sponsors, Hunky Dory, with Brian Peters Promotions, proudly present a night of championship boxing. We begin with an international light heavyweight contest scheduled for 6 3-minute rounds. Between and introducing, firstly, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the black trunks trimmed with white. He hails from Orlando in the United States of America, weighing in at 12 stone, 12 pound and 5 ounces. He brings with him a 35-5 professional record, consisting of 28 wins, 21 coming by way of knockout with 1 draw and 1 loss. Ladies and gentlemen, he's a former two-time WBA super middleweight champion of the world, Byron Mitchell!
So how much has he left in his tank? He's 36 years old.
And an opponent across the ring in the red corner, formerly from Cuba, now fights out of Cork, weighing in at 12 stone, 7 pound. He's undefeated as a professional, 8 wins from 8 contests. 6 of those wins, ladies and gentlemen, coming by way of the big knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting from Cork, Luis Garcia!
And he's but 22 years old.
Our officials this evening are appointed by the Boxing Union of Ireland, the timekeeper, Mr. Alex McKenzie, the referee for this contest, Mr. Mickey Van.
One of the most experienced referees in the world, Mickey Van.
You know the rules, obey my commands at all times. Break when you're told, take one step back. No noughties with the head. Shake hands, back to your corners, good luck.
Simple as
Six.
That, isn't it? How often has he said that? Well, another chance to see Garcia up against real opposition. A man who's been there, done that, run the block several times, 11 years ago. The world WBA champion. Byron Mitchell. First punch of the fight from Garcia, that left hand.
I'm just wondering, Jimmy, how much... Oh, that's a cracking left hook from Garcia again. Opening 2 shots, real good cracking punches. One a left hook, one a right hand from Garcia. But I'm just wondering, Jimmy, how much... Mitchell has left in that tank, I know he's an absolute world-class fighter, there's no doubt about that, two-time world champion, had quite a lot of world title fights, but how much has he got left in that tank? That's the question that has to be answered, and we'll know after 2 or 3 rounds what way this fight's going to go.
He's been in a lot of ring wars. This is the 36th fight of his career. One for every year of his age, and of course he wasn't fighting when he was 4 and 5. Or 1 and 2 and 3. Left hand looking good from Garcia in the early stages. Interesting side head approach. It's a characteristic of Mitchell. Look at that, the leaning head.
Let him go.
This is a real big step up in class for Garcia. And this is the first real first class, world class fighter that he's fought. So this will let us know how good Garcia really is. Because I know he's unbeaten, but he hasn't fought anybody of any note, Jimmy. You know, he's been fighting sort of hand-picked opponents the whole way through, which is natural at the start of your career. But this is his first real test.
No doubt about his ability. But now the opposition is stronger, better, wiser, more experienced. And 14 years as senior. Good right hand there. In fact, it's a good flurry altogether from Garcia. And most of them have been getting through. And that's against an experienced man with a very experienced professional guard. That head hanging to the left from Williams makes you think that he's got a muscle short on the left-hand side of his neck, but it's just an idiosyncrasy.
I can tell by the way Mitchell's moving here, Jimmy, that he's what you call a short fighter, because his movement's not as good, his legs are stiff, you know, his whole body's pretty stiff. He's not the fighter that he was, by no matter. He's what I would class almost as a shot fighter, which is a commonly known word in the world of boxing, because he doesn't move the way he did or once did. You know, he's stiff, he's rigid, and he just doesn't have that world class movement anymore. But he still can punch. That's one thing you don't lose.
You never lose the punch. And he certainly didn't lose it there. Garcia has certainly won the first round. He's looked good.
Good stuff from Garcia. That was a cracking left hook. He's a good, solid puncher, Garcia. But Mitchell seems to have a pretty solid chin, as his record suggests. But he just isn't moving the way that he moved like 5 years ago, 6 years ago. He's pretty stiff, he's pretty rigid, and he's finding it hard to get his own punches off. You nearly think that his timing was off completely, which happens to fighters who overtrain or undertrain.
Or been beaten up too often.
Is exactly right.
This man has the future, like all of us, ahead of him. Nobody has a future behind them that I know. But he's looked good. Luis Garcia, when we've seen him. But as Dave Boy McCauley has said already this evening, this is real experienced opposition. There's really no exceptional return coming from Mitchell at all. Now lives in Alabama.
Get the arm out, Byron.
A slammer from Bama. Hasn't looked as if he's going to slam tonight. But as we said before, you never lose the punch, but you do lose the ability to make the opportunities for it. And Garcia's living in his skin here.
Wait! Let him go! Let his head go.
Clear instructions from Mickey Van. And Mitchell taking a knee. And his eye is hurt. He's not playing possum, as the Americans might say. And then they say a lot of things. But certainly his eye is the cause of that.
See double in the eye.
And he's saying, I don't feel too good.
Let the doc have a look.
I think he's... Dave Boy McCauley thinks he's a shot fighter. And maybe that's his way out tonight.
Well, Byron Mitchell, in my eyes, Jimmy, wouldn't have done that 10 years ago. You know, fighters who have world class, no matter what you do to them, they'll get up and they'll fight back and they'll fight on, regardless if their arms are hanging off, their legs are hanging off.
It's over. Yeah. He didn't want to know. And in fairness to him, Dave Boy, you're on the mark as usual. A shot fighter is a beaten fighter. But he was hurt. There's no doubt he didn't lie down and take the money. But as you say, years ago, he would not have done that, you can believe me.
No, years ago he would have been still there. In fact, he'd been given Garcia like a harder time 10 years ago than what he did tonight. But I could tell by the way he moved at the start of the fight, the way he was rigid, he was stiff, you know, he wasn't the same relaxed that he normally would be. Because that means, what it proves is, when you see that in a ring, you know that the fighter's well past his sell-by date, and that's what Mitchell was tonight. But listen, he's had loads of experience. Nobody knew that it was going to be as quick as this, not even Garcia. Nobody expected this, but he's been hit loads of good shots here. But those punches wouldn't have had the same effect 10 years ago, because they're not devastating punches, but they're what you call hurtful punches.
And accurate. Yes, another good night for Luis Garcia, the big man from Cuba, big happy looking man from Cuba. Having a little private conversation with Mickey Van, to which we're not privy. And now here comes the Kodai, as the officials, Mike Goodall.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, after the 51 seconds of round two, the referee has called a halt to the contest with Byron Mitchell having sustained a damage to the left eye. Ladies and gentlemen, leading the winner, Luis Garcia.
Shorter fight than he might have expected. Perhaps a shorter fight that may have been useful for him.
Byron Mitchell.
The slammer from Bama. I'm afraid it's going to slam nobody this evening. Cut right across the lid of his eye. and he's gone. Adrian.
Thanks, Jimmy. Luis, very, very impressive.
Yeah, I'm very excited for this fight now because my opponents, I know it's very hard and famous as well. And he was champion of the world 2 times, so for me, it's a major victory, you know?
And to beat a 2-time world champion in the manner which you did, that's a real statement from you, isn't it?
Yeah, for me, it's a big step, you know? So we'll see in the next fight who's coming up, you know?
Clearly, the goal for you is to win a world title. How much further down the line is that for you?
I think for the world champion next year, probably, is for me, it's very soon because I'm in good condition. I have two good coach and my manager as well is very nice. So I'm happy, you know? When everything is happy, the thing's going right, you know?
So watch out, world.
Sorry?
Watch out, the world, eh? Well done tonight.
Thanks. Thank you very much.
The coach to him referred to Nicholas Hernandez, Nicholas Cruz Hernandez. And there isn't an Irish boxing fan who won't remember him. As I elbow the man who's sitting beside me, Michael Carruth, because he certainly will remember him more than any other man on earth. Memories of Barcelona.
Okay, Jim, thanks very much indeed. Very impressive from Luis Garcia, Mick, but the name of Byron Mitchell will look good on Luis's CV, but surely he's got it longer in the ring.
Yeah, well, you know, one look at the his record suggested what might happen, you know. Right. 5 of his last 8 fights all finished inside the distance. Yeah, he was a spent champion, as their boy said, a shot champion. He's been there, he's done it all. And you've heard me talk many times on this program about fighters that go in the mid-30s and so on. And there are the odd, occasional, exceptional fighters who go well beyond their mid-30s and so on. But they have to be exceptional. Byron Mitchell was not one of those exceptional fighters. He wasn't an exceptional fighter even when he was champion. Right. And I think the writing was on the wall from early on.
Yeah, in some respects, we'll talk about Luis Garcia in a minute, but it's kind of sad, really, what happened to Mitchell there, isn't it? And like, yeah, well, you guys looking at him felt the same as Dave Boy did from the very first bell. The guy
the
was
moment spent. I seen him getting into the ring, I said, you know, he looks, you know, loose. He wasn't in shape, and he looked old. And the moment Garcia came out, you know, Wright was on the wall for the fight to be stopped. He looked disinterested at the end of the fourth round. And myself and Jim were saying we didn't think he'd come back out. Yeah. As soon as he came back out and took a shot, he didn't want to know. The thing that impressed me about Garcia, you know, in his last fight against Oliveira, you know, he looked disinterested, you know, and I think he needs to be challenged. He needs somebody who's going to, you know, force him into a fight. You know, tonight he thought he was up against a challenge and he came out and he exploded. You know, he threw shots in abundance and he was more active than I think he was in the whole of his last fight.
Just how good is this guy, Jim?
Well, he seems very, very good. I wouldn't like to be in there to ring with him, man. I mean, he throws punches with very wicked intentions. And I mean, and he has every punch in the book. If you look at the punches he was hitting them, left hooks, right uppercuts. I mean, he just had terrific array of punches and all of them are landing with great power, you know. So he's definitely one to watch and I can certainly see him fighting for a world title next year and possibly winnable.
Yeah, he's ready for that step, is he, Bernard?
Well, they're keeping him active, you know. The 7th fight this year, you know. It's one thing keeping active. I think now they need to start stepping him up, his team, whether it be Brian or whoever it is that's looking after him. I think they need to start challenging him and, you know, and making him think in there when he's in the ring. He's having too much of his own way. I think if he's going to challenge for the world title next year, he's going to need to be, you know, tested at some point.
Well, I think he is being challenged by these guys because for a guy that's only had 8 fights, I mean, he's ranked in the top 50 in the world and he's going to go up higher now because of this fight. So, I mean, like, fellas usually with 8 fights would not be near that in the rankings. So he is beating fellas that are up there in the rankings, you know, and I just think because he's such a good fighter, he's making these fighters look so ordinary.
Yeah, he is a very good fighter, but, you know, you would have to say, and I remarked straight away, that Byron Mitchell walked out, all pro style, carrying this hand here. The Cuban looked at him straight away. I could see a left hook is the first shot I'm going to throw. He threw the very first shot, left hook, nailed him right on the chin. Yeah. So the writing was going to be on the wall from early on. The Cuban is too cute. He's had a good amateur career, as you know, world junior champion. So he was able to see immediately where the openings were.
Let's have a look at him in action. We've some action selected here from the end of round one. Really, the theme here is that from the first bell, Garcia was on this guy. Nick?
Well, here you are. This is a young man with real, real world potential, and he's taking on an old spent fighter. He's opening up here. Byron Mitchell hasn't an idea of how to get out of the way. The reflexes are just gone, and so certainly the chin, I wouldn't be too strong either at this stage. I mean, he's happy to get out of it at this stage. He's 36, he's 37 years old. He wanted an easy way out, and maybe I'm being a bit hard on him, but really, I think he was a well-spent fighter, and he's quite happy to get out of the fight this early on.
There's a magazine called Boxing News. In the past, they have told us about a fellow called Mike Tyson saying, look, this guy, this is years ago, this guy is going to be the next big thing in boxing. They've also spoken about Nassim Hamed well before he had any kind of a presence, even in the UK. In recent times, they have tipped this guy, Luis Garcia, saying they've seen him in sparring, Bernard, and he is absolutely magic.
You know, and that's probably the point I'm trying to make, you know. Garcia's team must be licking their lips for what they have in their hands. You know, this is a kid who can actually win a world title next year. You know, and that's why I think he can make bigger leaps than he's already making. You know, this is an amazing kid. Got all the punches, looks after himself. He's in great shape there. You know, I would like to see him more active like he was here today in the ring. You know, the last couple of fights I've watched him, you know, he's kind of realised, you know, these guys aren't up to my standard. And he's, you know, he's treated them with contempt.
Except, like, tonight we saw him at the end, he hardly had broken into a sweat, Jim.
No, but I mean, when from the word go tonight, he was a different fighter than he was for the last couple of times. The last couple of times we've seen him, he knew he wasn't up against someone like the fellow tonight. So tonight, being up against a two-time world champion, it brought the best out of him. As sometimes when you fight fighters who are really, really good, have really good records, and they'll bring the best out in a fighter.
All right, well, we've seen a very impressive performance. Another one, yet again, from Luis Garcia. He reckons he might get a crack at the world title next year, and the boys here certainly believe that he is ready for that. Tonight, though, in Limerick, our main event is coming up after the break, and it's all about a title Bernard Dunne won 4 years ago, the European Super Bantamweight Championship. Willie Casey and Paul Hyland, tonight they mean business, but last week when Jimmy McGee caught up with them, they were in flying form. Back after the break.
I've seen a parish priest in the gym as a man prepares for a title fight. Who is this man?
That's Faravan. He's with the club the last 20 years.
So will you be the holiest European champion?
I wouldn't say that.
How many cuts have you had in your life?
In boxing, in the pros, none.
Because you have no scars that I can see.
There's a few scars there, Ollie, but...
They're hidden.
They're not from the boxing.
Well, the man's getting ready with the music now. What's it going to be?
Molly Malone. It has to be Molly Malone.
What, a jazz-up version, a rap version? Of the
No, the original Dubliners, live Dubliners.
Really?
Yeah.
Who's singing on it?
The Dubliners. I have the Dublin people come down, will be supporting me, you know, like, you know what I mean? Do you know what I mean? Then?
No, I'd suffer if I had that.
I would be reluctant.
I'd be a bit nervous of the pain on the front of my teeth.
Wouldn't be too happy about it.
Oh, that's going to hurt.
No, I couldn't. No pain.
Perfect.
It makes a real difference.
So I can go and have a drink in peace now.
Great, that's great. Can I have some more?
Magic.
This Sunday we bring you Ireland's most comprehensive crime survey. Has violent crime escalated? Which communities are most at risk? And who do you think the real criminals are? Read my exclusive story only in the Irish News of the World.
The big stories from the big names. Only 150 and only in the Irish News of the World.
Welcome to Jackass!
Jackass 3D.
High five!
Only in 3D.
Yeah.
have to learn anything you don't already know. Or do anything you don't already do. All you have to do is be you. You are the controller.
Keeps on listening in. Nobody's listening.
Introducing Kinect for Xbox 360.
All right, Ray.
You couldn't get a word in with your man yesterday.
Not a word from him. It's just not on.
You wanted so much makeup on, you couldn't see your nose.
It's all about evolution.
Revolution!
They wouldn't put up with this in France.
So brave. How does that woman get up in the morning?
And did you hear this morning? They're splitting it in two.
As if one wasn't bad enough.
Bad bubbles, Peter.
There's nothing that can't be improved by putting an egg on top of it. Talk to you in the morning.
The Ray Darcy Show on Today FM.
Andy Murray and Paul Hyland's brother Patrick are the headliners in our next Pro Box Live show. That takes place a fortnight from now when Murray faces the world number 14, Claudine Lacerda from Brazil, and Hyland takes on Italian featherweight Massimo Mora. It all gets underway at 9:30 on the 20th of November, right here on RTE2. Now let's hear from the two boys. Andy and Patrick are here in Limerick this evening, looking ahead no doubt to the 20th of November, but a big night for Patrick and his brother Paul. The two lads are now with Adrian Eames.
Yes, thanks very much, Dara. Down here ringside, Patrick Hyland and Andy Murray, as you say. Patrick, you've just been inside the dressing room with Paulie. How's he feeling ahead of the big contest?
Very confident, very relaxed. He's looking sharp in there. I went in, he was more relaxed than I was. I was more nervous for him, and he just goes, all right, bro, and just time to take this belt home to Tally.
No inhibitions about coming into the Lion's Den, coming into Limerick to wrestle this belt away back to Dublin?
No, not really. It doesn't faze him at all. Like, he's boxed down here before a few times, but it wasn't for anything as big as this against a local boy, but it doesn't faze him whatsoever. Like, you know, he's a professional at the end of the day and has to do his job, and his job is to take that belt back to Tally, and that's what he's going to do.
You're, of course, preparing for Castlebar like Andy here alongside you. How are preparations going for that?
Yeah, preparations going great. I was in training camp with Paulie there himself. I was pushing Paulie hard and getting hard training myself. So preparations going great for that one as well. Can't wait.
So I've no doubt tonight, though, you're backing Paulie to win. Will it go the distance?
I reckon a late stoppage by Paulie. If not, will be distance, yeah. Points win for Paul, yeah.
Okay, to go the distance. Andy Murray alongside Patrick Hyland. Many thanks, Patrick. How do you see it going?
I see it as a very close fight, and if I was a betting man, I'd probably favour Paulie on points. But being the venue and the occasion, and Willie's going to really be up for it, you just never know. It's a hard one to call.
That hometown momentum here in Limerick, the man from South Hill, the crowd will certainly be on his side.
He definitely was, but you have to remember Paul went to Italy and took away the European title from there, European Union title from there. So it's not really going to faze him, but it'll be a big boost for Willie Casey.
Well, it's a real contrast in styles. Just you're preparing, of course, for Castlebar this night, fortnight, against Claudinine Carceda from Brazil. You're putting your 22 fight unbeaten record on the line. How are preparations going, and how do you feel about Castlebar in coming up in a fortnight?
Yeah, I'm looking forward. I boxed there before, and it's a great venue, and the training's going great. I'm more or less going into my last hard week, and I couldn't be happier with preparations, and I have a great fight in front of me with number 14 ranked in the world, but it's what you want now at this stage of my career is a step up and a bit of a challenge, and I'm looking forward to it.
Well, the best of luck to you both, but in the meantime, enjoy tonight.
Adrian, thanks very much indeed. Well, we heard from Patrick about how relaxed Paul is. There's the two boys going through their pre-fight routine. They will be out in the arena here at the University of Limerick in just a couple of minutes' time. Great anticipation around the arena this evening. Almost a full house here, but great atmosphere. It's been building all day, and we'll see the boys in action very shortly. But let's hear from the two of them. They've been chatting with Jimmy.
Can he keep you away for 12 rounds?
He can, in order if he has two big sledgehammers inside his gloves. And he just keep hitting me with them. I'm sure he'll wear me down eventually, like, you know. But once that bell goes, like, you're going to expect me to be on top of him the whole way, like, you know.
I have my own little game plan, and I'm sure Willie has his game plan as well, so. We have our own little
ideas of what we have to do to fight Willie Casey, you know.
It's okay having the big bang, and, you know, and when you're landed, you know what I mean, it can have a big effect on an opponent. But it's all about having to land it as well. In my amateur career, it was the only thing I was thinking about was going in trying to dig the head off everyone, like, you know what I mean? And I was getting countered every time, and I was losing fights all the time. But it's different in the programme now. I'm more elusive, I'm more relaxed, and I'm not actually looking for it. It's actually just coming natural now at this stage, to be honest.
He's going to have a lot to do to bang me out there, and that's not going to happen. You know, I'm prepared to go for 12 rounds through war to get that to the European title, you know.
I've trained now, and I've trained very hard for this fight, and I've trained for 12 rounds and a few extra rounds as well if we have to do it. I'm prepared for whatever way it goes, like, you know what I mean? And I can't take anything for granted in this game, like, you know what I mean? People say he can't bang. I think he can.
I can bang when I want to bang, you know, but my style is just... I sussed them out in the first two rounds, and I just picked my shots, and I damaged them with the shots, you know. I like to hurt my opponents. I make sure that when they're in a 12-round fight with me, they don't want to get in the ring with me again.
Paddy's, he's professional 6 years now, like, you know, and he learnt it the slow way and the long way, do you know what I mean? But if you look at my opponents now, like, you know what I mean, I've learnt it the fast way. I've learnt how to box, I've learnt how to move, and it's all coming, and I'm still a little bit raw, I have to admit, like, you know. I'm always learning. You can never know too much in this game.
There's about 600 people going down already in a week's notice already.
From Jobstown
and Tallaght alone, and then I have a few of the Shamrock Rovers players coming down as well, and they recently won the league, so it's going to be a good night for Tallaght people as well, you know.
Well, there's 21 in the family, so you can imagine they'll all be there with all their sister-in-laws, brother-in-laws, nephews, nieces, and if some of the uncles and cousins as well, maybe, I'm sure. You're talking a couple of hundred people, like, you know.
That's the place nearly half full.
Well, it'll be a good fair percentage of it now, like, you know. It'll be, especially if being in Limerick, then, like, you know, you can expect a good crowd, like, you know.
So that could be a telling factor in the later rounds, you know, with the body shots I do be thrown in, but I come to this fight on the 6th of November, the winner, and I show everybody what Kika Martinez is really made of, you know, and that's just a one-dimensional fighter.
Here we are now with a European title, like, you know, so I'm going to take it, and I'm going to take it good, like, you know what I mean? And when I do win it, then, like, you know what I mean, it's going to be very hard to take it off me then as well. In my mind, I'm already European champion anyway, like, you know, so maybe that's why I feel so confident at the moment, you know, so it's interesting, you know.
Yeah, they're two great characters. You will have seen them on the telly last week with Brendan O'Connor. They know each other well. They've sparred together in the past, but the friendliness that was there, that's all forgotten. The level of noise, by the way, has just gone up a couple of notches in the arena in the last couple of minutes. Mick, let's have a look at just how, we've talked a lot about how powerful Willie Casey is. Big Bang is his nickname. Just talk to us about how aggressive he is.
Willie Casey, well, it would be wrong to say he knows only one way of fighting, and that is to go forward, because Willie surprised me when I saw him at City West there about 2 months ago, when he was able to box as well as fight. But generally it would be accepted that Willie Casey is the fighter. He is the guy with the power. He is the guy that's going to want to land the big stuff. But he has been working very, very well on technique. He's working out at Crumlin Boxing Club along with Phil Sutcliffe. And I have to say, I was impressed with him when I saw him at City West. Very, very good. He's got a right attitude, good temperament. He is very, very fit. He will pile on pressure, and I think he's going to try and mix his boxing and his fighting, because I did have a word with him in the dressing room, as I did with Pauly Hyland, and he is going to try and mix the two of boxing and fighting, and I think that's a good idea, because he reckons Pauly will expect me to go out throwing leather from all angles, but I'm not going to do that. He said, I'm going to go out, I'm going to box, I'll fight when I have to fight, and I'll box again.
Well, I wouldn't believe that now.
Would you not?
I wouldn't believe he's going to come out and box.
I think he will.
And I'd say he's telling everyone he's going to box, and thinking it's going to get back to Hyland. And I say he's going to come out then.
Some
old
fashioned psychology.
That's what I reckon, because that's the way Willie Casey is. He's a born fighter.
I think the crowd will get to him as well.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe.
Minute of the bell. We'll get to him in a negative way.
I think, you know, he can have the best laid plans. But I think Willie is that type of fighter that, you know, he feeds off adrenaline, and this type of atmosphere, he'll just go gung-ho, you know.
Yeah, you can.
But I think the one thing Willie has to do when he is being aggressive and being attacking, keep them hands really high up and walk forward and walk Hyland down. That has to be his tactics. You know, if he keeps them hands low, Hyland will pick him off. That jab off Hyland will work well.
The atmosphere just bubbling nicely behind us. Let's have a look at Paul Hyland, because Bernard, he's described as, you know, this classic style. He's a more stylish boxer, and Willie Casey admits that himself.
He is, you know, but, you know, see this left hand down. Paul is going to have to keep that up here today, you know, and he's going to have to be very selective with his shots. He can't be just throwing shots against Willie, because Willie's going to be constant pressure, and it's going to make you work hard. So the shots you do throw against him, you want to make sure you're scoring, and you're not hitting those body shots off the elbow or the arm. You want to be making sure you're seeing the space and hitting that space and causing problems for Willie and making Willie think about coming in. Now, if Willie's able to walk forward without having to think about, I'm going to get hit with this, I'm going to get hit with that. No, you want to make sure, Willie, you keep coming, you're going to keep getting hit with this. And that's what Paulie has to do here today.
Yeah, Paul Hyland is a very, very good technician. He's learned his boxing very, very well. 6 years as a pro. He's been through the amateurs. And on this same program here, I've talked before about, I always like the guys who have served a good amateur apprenticeship. And Paulie Hyland has certainly done that. Two national titles of his own. He's a fitness fanatic as well. His brothers are the same. Always in really, really good shape. Good technical fighter. The question you will be asking is, does he have the power to stop Willie Casey marching forward? If you listen to the Hyland camp, they would say he absolutely does. He's a very sharp hitter.
If he doesn't have that power, does he have the engine to be able to keep running forward?
I think, I've said, you know, that I think he's always very, very fit, Bernard.
Yeah.
You know, and I think he'll be able to hold the pressure off.
Yeah.
But to land the punches, that's Willie Casey's problem. If he gets the punches on target, Big Bang himself said, I've got to land the punches. If he does, it could be trouble for Hyland. But if it goes to points, Hyland is in with a really, really good shout here.
It's hard to see past him on points.
Well, we'll find out in due course. The weigh-in took place in the University of Limerick yesterday. 28-year-old Willie Casey tipped the scales at 8 stone, 9 pounds and 3 ounces. Paul Hyland weighed in at 8 stone, 9 pounds and 7 ounces. So just 4 ounces between them yesterday. And as you can see there, Hyland has a 2-inch height advantage, and there's a 3-year age gap between the two men. Okay, guys, I want a name. Who's going to be European super bantamweight champion?
I'm sitting on the fence here. If it's inside the distance, I go for Casey. If it's on points, I'm going to go for Hyland.
Bernard.
Again, if Casey gets his tactics right in the first 4 rounds and pressures, but is defensive in his pressure, keeps his hands up, you know, he's going to wear Hyland down. I think he can do him in 5-8. If not, and if, you know, he's lackadaisical with his defence. He's lackadaisical with his defence. You know, if Paulie can box and move, and if Casey's lackadaisical with his defence, he's going to get picked off.
Jim.
Yeah, if Paulie can stick to his boxing for 12 rounds, but I think Willie Casey will wear him down, and I'd say Willie Casey for between 6 and 9 stoppage.
All right, let's find out. Let's join. Go down to the ring and join ring announcer Mike Goodall.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the main event of the evening. Please welcome firstly into the ring, Paul
Hyland with the Dubliners and a big crowd down here from Jokestown and Tala to support our man. Imagine how nervous he is, and indeed his whole family. The three boxing brothers, each of whom is ranked in the top 10. That's in the British rankings. Paul professional. Only one loss, and that was to Lucien Gonzalez in Philadelphia 2 years ago. A harsh decision by all accounts. And here he is. Patrick Eddy and this man, Paulie, the three boxing brothers, 2 years between them on age. 25, 27, 29. Paulie's 25. Couple of weeks' time, he will be 26. He is the European Union champion. Beats Chianella in Naples 7 months ago. But this is for the real European title. Jazza there with him. He's been with him from the Golden Cobra Club when he was at the height of his amateur career. And not forgetting, too, that Paulie Hyland, as an amateur, won everything available to him, from boy one right up through juniors, intermediate, youths before that, and a couple of seniors.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to welcome the Pride of Limerick, Willie!
Big Bang Willie. Only 10 professional fights. It's almost a Roy of the Rovers thing, or the equivalent of boxing. To think that already he's won the prize fighter for his biggest purse, three fights in the one night. And here he is fighting for the European Super Bantamweight Championship. That truly is Roy of the Rovers stuff. Marvelous reception for him too, as you might expect here in this native city. Big Bang's in the ring. There's the card, 10 fights, 10 wins. Three fight wisdom suggests Hyland the boxer, Kessie the fighter, but it's not as straightforward as the stereotype. Mike Goodall again.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please be upstanding for the national anthem to be sung by Derek Malone. Judges, scoring the contest at ringside on the 10-match system, Mr. Richie Davis of England, Mr. Franco Chirinel of Austria, and Mr. Ernst Spoltsgerger from Austria also. And when the action begins, our third man in the ring this evening from England, Mr. John Keane. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the featured main event of the evening, live and exclusive on RTE Sport. From the University Arena in Limerick, Brian Peters, in association with our sponsors, Hunky Dory, proudly presents a unique title contest. 12 three-minute round duration to decide the vacant European Super Bantamweight Championship. Between and introducing the boxers, and firstly, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the dark blue trunks, truly light blue. He comes from Dublin and weighed in at 8 stone, 9 pounds and 7 ounces. He brings to the ring a 19-5 record, 18 wins, 5 wins by way of knockout, with 1 loss. Ladies and gentlemen, he comes to the ring tonight as a former undefeated European Union Super Bantamweight Champion. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Paul Hyland! And his opponent, ladies and gentlemen, across the ring in the red corner, wearing the dark trunks trimmed with the grey. Ladies and gentlemen, he weighed in at 8 stone, 9 pounds and 3 ounces. He comes to the ring tonight, undefeated as a professional. 10 big wins from 10 big contests. 6 wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, he's the prize fighter champion and the pride of Limerick. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight, fighting in his native city of Limerick, ladies and gentlemen, Willie! Big Bang Casey! Referee, Mr. John Keane will now give his final instructions to both boxers.
Casey!
Well, you received your instructions in the dressing room. You're not going to expect them, both of you. Shake hands and come out boxing.
12 3-minute rounds for the vacant.
Eventually and shortly, all of the support players will leave the ring and leave it to 3 men: Willie Casey, Paulie Hyland, and John Keane, the referee. The talk is over. It's time for the action. It's full set up there. Twice a European bronze medalist. Just indeed as one of our panelists, Mick Darling, was twice a European medalist. I think Bucharest and Madrid. But this is Limerick tonight. And straight away, Casey jumps out of his corner. And that, I suppose, is fairly predictable. Casey, in case you didn't know already, a southpaw. This is the makings of an all-action fight, a really all-action fight. They say styles make fights. Well, this is the contrast in styles. When you say that Hyland is the boxer and Casey the fighter, that does scant justice to both men in the other direction, because Hyland too can carry a punch and Willie can box.
It's early days yet, but Casey hasn't come out, you know, throwing big wild bombs or big left hooks. He's actually boxing more than I've ever seen him boxing before, you know, and he's thinking here. But that young guy, Hyland, he's got a good left hook to the body. I mean, this will be probably Hyland's best punch to be throwing. And that's what a southpaw is open for. And a good solid left hook into the short rim.
What an opening round.
It's fantastic already.
I mean, the action is brilliant. Good shots been thrown by both men. And there's still a minute and 40 to go in the round. It's that left hook going into the body again from Hyland. It's a good punch now.
That was a nice, good straight 1-2 that Hyland also caught. Casey with they both landed bang on target.
Willie only 2 years of pro. This is only his 11th fight. Too many. one in Limerick, three in Dublin, one in Cork, one in Killarney, one in Toronto, and then those famous three in the York Hall on the 29th of May 2010. That's the night he won the prize fight.
You see what either fighter doesn't want to do here is to get wide. You see, when you get wide, you make mistakes and you leave yourself wide open. And whoever leaves themselves too wide open can get tagged with a big left or a big right. So they have to keep their composure. And Hyland is doing lovely stuff here, boxing to the head under the body, and so is Casey. This at the minute, Jimmy, is a toss-up.
But it's only the first round.
Well, it's like our front room, but right now there's nothing in it.
It was a difficult one to three-fight call. And even after the evidence of a minute and a, or 2.5 minutes, it's still difficult to call. Hyland is able to put ones, twos and threes together. Last 10 seconds of the round. And this has been one really very, very good round. Great uppercut there from Casey. And that livens the crowd. And that's been as good a first round as you could possibly see in a title fight, any place, anywhere.
Yep, fantastic stuff here from both fighters. They both come out, but Casey didn't come out wild. He's fighting a thinking man's fight. He's picking his shots, and he's looking what he's doing. He's not throwing big, wide, sweeping right hands or left hooks. It's very, very, very good stuff from Casey. He's surprising me, but it's also good stuff from young Hyland, who's boxing very well and putting some very good combinations together, especially that left hook to the short rib. It's a devastating punch, and when it lands, it causes you all kinds of problems.
That man in the ring with him there is Patrick Hyland, his father. Great boxing man who went, been right through the amateurs with his three sons. Now proud he must be tonight. Phil Sutcliffe is in the corner there, urging on the crowd not to need much encouragement. As we come up for round two, scheduled for 12, already it's been a cracker. See how neat and tidy the punching of Hyland is. He can pick shots well. And this is one thing Willie doesn't intend to do, to give him time to compose himself. The right hand came through well there from Casey.
Two good solid body shots there from Casey. Powerful stuff. I can tell you, Jim, you see, for 10 fights, he's a very, he looks like a very, very experienced fighter, Casey. He looks like he's an established pro. For somebody having so few fights, like 10 fights, you think he would have 25 or 30 fights away. He's performing in the way he's conducting himself in the ring.
But sure, he's not novice-like, that's for certain. He's a fighter. Steve McCauley put his finger absolutely on it. There's nothing novice-y at all about Willie Casey, both in his defence, in his attack, and in the way he's carried himself into this fight against the very composed, accurate and skillful Hyland. Really good contest, this one, for the Championship of Europe.
This could come right down to, Jimmy, whatever one of these guys has trained the hardest and sacrificed in the gym, because this is a really fast fought pace here, and you just can't continue that for 12 rounds. So whatever person has put in the gym and trained his ass off and left nothing to chance, that's the guy looking at it right now who's got the best chance of winning this European title.
More or less exchanging punches, one for one. Watch the Hyland left hand, it's a good left hand. He takes the right hand on the left arm. Each in turn having a little flurry.
See, what Head is doing is right now, he's getting involved in a brawl. He's a boxer, he's not a fighter, so he wants to get on his bike and move. What he's doing now, he's sitting Willie Casey right down to the ground. He's coming in close, and Willie Casey just loving this because he can let the punches go from every angle, and Hyland is standing right in front of him. Even though he's well covered up, he's still shifting some punches here, and he wants to get on his bike and do what he does best, and that is box.
Yes, at distance. That would appear to be the best method for Pauly Hyland. Good exchange. Hooks, uppercuts, head punches, body punches. This is a little of everything. Oh, there's a left hook from Hyland, a really good left hook. to the head and then tried one to the body, and back comes Casey with his flurry. If you're looking for big time stuff, this is big time stuff in the University of Limerick. Cracking, absolutely cracking European title fight. Another terrific run from two really creditable fighters. The European Championship has come to Ireland, and for the first time, two Irishmen are going hell for leather for it. Great punching, great skill from both men. Dave, this is a cracker.
Yeah, first class. Look, you can see the quality of the punches here. They're in close, they're fighting, and they're giving their all. But Hyland's a boxer, so what he wants to do, if I was in his corner right now, he's saying, listen, get on your bike, box and move, throw the hard punches, put power behind, but box and move, because when you get in close, you're sitting Willie Casey. This is what he wants. He wants you in there. He wants you just to entice you into to the lion's den, and that's what Hyland's doing right now. He's doing well right now, but he could do things a wee bit better and a wee bit easier for himself if he was to get on his bike and box.
Round three. Has Tall Casey in the black trunks and wearing the blue and very dark navy, the Dublin colours, Paulie Hyland. I check with the man himself if Paulie's right, and Paulie it is. His uncle is Paul, so it makes it easier for the family. If one is Paul and one is Paulie, so as not being too familiar with him, call him Paulie. Just to clear that up.
Stop boxing! Stop boxing!
The thing that's astonishing, and Dave Boyle McCauley has took notice of it, is that Willie Casey is tonight only in his 11th fight. And in fact, this round he's boxing now is only the 47th round of his professional career. And yet, look at it. Look at the way he's set up. His posture and his punching, it's hard to believe.
Yeah, he's a true pro in every sense of the word. But what Hyland wants to do here, if I was, I said this, what Hyland wants to do, you have to forget about the crowd. You have to do what you do best, and that's box. And what he's not doing is, right now, Hyland is letting that left hook go to the body as often as what he should be, because he's not doing his normal thing, which is on his bike and move around, pick his shots, move in, move out and away, and let that left hook go to the body, because that's the one that creates a lot of damage and wears your opponent down. But what he's doing is, right now, he's fighting the fight that Casey wants, because Casey doesn't have to go looking for him, because he's right there in front of him.
Yes, he doesn't have to look for him at all. That left hand going into the body again from Ireland is probably his best punch. And his defence is good too, because that last four or five punches that Casey has thrown, every one of them was taken on the arms and those legs by Tyler. But the last one got through. And listen to the crowd here in this magnificent arena. They're going potty for Big Bang. Inside the last minute of the third.
You see, what Hyland should be doing right now is to be on that bike and boxing, get that jab going, let the right hands go, the left hook go, because this is what he has to do. You know, like, he's there on the ropes, and in my eyes, this is all to please the crowd. You want to forget about the crowd, but then put the crowd behind you and do what you do best. Look at this. Normally when you see Paulie Hyland, he's boxing, he's on his toes, jabs out, left hooks go to the body, under the head. I haven't seen a big lot of that from the start of this fight, because he wants to fight, he wasn't involved in this brawl.
He wants to show that he can fight just as Casey can, but at least Casey's boxing the fight tonight, and a very good third round, and Casey's run. He's so confident now, he's just blowing a kiss to somebody in the audience, to whom, how do I know? Because there must be, there's 500 people here.
See,
obviously supporting Big Bang.
Great stuff here from both fighters again, but Hyland gets caught when he's inside, and if he did what he does best, as I've been saying, is box. But you can box and fight, you just don't have to be on your bike all the time. The good stiff jabs, good solid 1-2, bang the left hook to the body, and then move. Don't stay there and admire the work that you've just done. Get on your bike and do a move.
flies all the time. Busy on this.
And Ryan also there in the corner with Polly Hyland. Phil Sutcliffe, Willie Casey. Round four, scheduled for 12. One quarter way gone. Hyland assuming a very wide stance at the top of this round.
I'll tell you what Hyland's doing very, which is very dangerous. See that left hand? That left hand's down in where his waistband is. And if Casey gets that right hook off and it goes according to plan, if that lands, it'll do a bit of damage because Hyland's hand is right down level with his waistband, which is in the wrong place entirely.
Cooler start to this round though by Paulie Hyland.
See, this is what Hyland should be doing, in and out move, box and move. Like, you don't have to be on the retreat all the time. Go forward, throw two or three punches, then move away. But he's doing that a wee bit more now, and he's moving a wee bit more now, but he's been a wee bit negative in this round. He's not throwing the same punches. Once he lets him go, move, get out of the way. When he stands, he gets tagged, like what's happening right now. I know the punches aren't landing on the target, but still, it makes you think and it wears you down. I don't know what's going through young Henry's mind here. He's not doing what he normally does do, and that's box and move. He's just staying here, and he's getting tight, and he's getting broken down here. Because those are pretty powerful punches going in there from Casey. And what they'll do is, they'll wear Hyland down. They'll obviously take their toll on Casey also.
And the referee intervenes. And Willie Casey, Big Bang Willie, has done it. Paulie Hyland took this fight at a fortnight's notice, and it was supposed to be Kiko Martinez boxing for this title. Fantastic, incredible atmosphere. Casey went at it. Unbelievable percentage of punches from Casey. And I'll tell you something, he's standing in that ring just above me now. I hope his footwork is good and he doesn't fall on top of me. Big Bang has done it, and I'll tell you one thing here, you could measure the atmosphere on the Richter scale in Limerick. Willie Casey is the champion of Europe. Hard to believe, it's his 11th professional fight, and not alone in the year of 2010. Has he become the champion of Europe? He also won at the famous York Hall in Bethnal Green. He won the prize fighter. It's a disappointed, unhappy Paulie Hyland. But it was like a storm that has been forecast by the weatherman. Has come a night early to Ireland, certainly to Limerick. And the storm, I think it's called Thomas now, that storm across the Atlantic, but you could call it Big Bang Willie instead, because that was a storm in round four. Quite good on.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 2 minutes and 9 seconds of the fourth round, the referee has stopped the contest in the interest of Paul Hyland's own safety. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner and the new European Super Bantamweight Champion, Willie Big Bang Casey!
introduce here Kiko Martinez. He was introduced earlier on. I think Kiko will fancy an evening in the company of Big Bang Willie in the ring. Now, Adrian Eames has found his way into the ring without gloves. And here he is with the new European champion.
Thanks very much, Jimmy. European champion, Willie. How does that sound?
Oh, it sounds amazing. Who knew after 2 years only in the pro game, after coming back from winning Pride Fair, we'd make European champion, like, you know? It's excellent. And it's all the hard work that we put in from my coaches, the Dalvin Promotions, and my strength and conditioning coach, Joe Clifford. We made a great team, and we're in it all the way now. There's no backing out now.
Only 2 years of pro, as you say. What took you so long?
I was tearing handy, like, you know, I wasn't sure if I wanted to do it or not. No, it's amazing. This is what I want to show my family, why I've been away for the last 8 weeks training. And you can see how proud they are, and my father here as well, to wish me luck, and my mother as well, of course, and my son as well. And for all my coaches, and for Joe and Bonnie Clifford, who let me stay in the house.
Yes.
I had to stay there. He's looking, you know, you have to.
So
but everything went well. We knew exactly what Paulie was going to do. We knew that he was going to trade with us. We had a feeling that he was going to stand with us. And we said that we'll... If he stands with us, we're all in good. Like, you know, we knew Paddy's plan. He was going to try and outbox me then after 4 or 5 rounds. But
it was a cracking fight. Absolutely amazing to watch.
Yeah, it was excellent. I mean, for the fella that had all that skill and technique, like, to stand in the ring with me, knowing that I was a banger and that I could have hurt him any time, and he still stuck in the middle of the ring to prove a point that I wasn't going to push him over. And I suppose at the end it was a little bit too much, but... All my respect to Paddy. Like, you've seen what happened, Bonner Dunn came back.
Yeah.
Bonner Dunn came back and won a world title after getting beaten by Little Tyson over here, as they call him. And he went down and won a world title. And there's no reason why Paddy can't do it either, because he has the skill and the technical ability to do it.
Well, now you're going to have to defend this title against Little Tyson, as you call him, Kiko Martinez. Everybody's wondering, when's that fight going to happen?
Yeah, I suppose it could be 6 months. Brian Peterson is the man running the show. Could be 5-6 months, but in the meantime, my own team, Dalvin Promotion, are running 2 shows, one in the 10th of December in the basketball arena, and one in January, and we're going to talk now to see if we're going to go on to 2 of them or the 1 of them, and that will give me another little bit of few rounds and a bit of experience to meet this man here then after that.
Kiko, how impressed were you by Willie Big Bang Casey?
Me pareció una buena pelea.
It seemed to be a good fight.
Le doy la enhorabuena por ganar.
And he congratulates you for winning, but Paul Hyland fought the wrong fight. He fought your fight.
Ha sido muy fuerte.
You were very strong.
That means Bernard fought the wrong fight as well.
Que si Bernard Dandy se peleó la pelea que tú querías. Dile lo que decías tú del cinturón.
Ah, la enhorabuena a todo. Y que se lo he prestado hasta el 5 de febrero.
He said it was a good fight, but he's a real champion, and you've only borrowed the belt till February or March, whenever you fight him.
Luego me lo tendrá que devolver.
And then you'll have to give it back to him.
I'm very grateful that he gave up the belt for myself and Paulie for the first 2 Irish fellas ever to fight for the belt. But as long as I have this belt, no one is taking it off me.
Well, there you have it. That bounce is going to South Hill. Phil Sutcliffe, what a performance.
Fantastic performance. Everything that we expected. I know Paulie, who was an excellent European Union champion, an excellent Irish champion. We know his skill, but we knew how to handle him. Right? And when you have the power that Willie Casey has, and now he's proved that he could box when he beat Emilio Salvini in City West. And now we've got to prove he can box and fight and punch with the best. Because in fairness to Paulie, he is one of the best. And I know Willie will say the same. Right? So we have to say, what we have to say is, right, apart from the show on the 10th of December in the basketball arena, what we have to say is, Kiko, you want to be right, because we're coming to get you.
Yeah. Yeah. Well done, Willie Big Bang Casey.
Thank you.
Well, fantastic stuff. Boxing has a new star, Willie Casey, winning that European title in such impressive fashion. You see Kiko Martinez there, Phil Sutcliffe as well, who not so long ago said that Willie Casey would win the European title in 3 years. He's done it in two. Bernard, you were getting a bit of stick there in the ring, but in a nice way. But this is a fabulous story.
I wish they'd leave me alone. I'm tired now, you know. I want to be left out of the equation. Stop picking on me. You know, what a performance by Willie. You know, I think Paulie was... I don't know what got into his head. He stood close, wanted to try and prove he was bigger, stronger than Willie. You know, I have no idea what the tactics were going in, but, you know, they were wrong if that was the plan. You know, he should have been giving himself space, making Willie miss, countering and moving, making the fight easy for him. Paulie Hyland is an intelligent guy. He can box so much better than he fought. Tonight he tried to brawl with a brawler. Big mistake.
Yeah, Jim, we heard in Willie's interview with Adrian, he said we knew how Paul would approach this, we knew how to handle him, but if that's not his natural strength and he was going to get hurt, which he did, just answer the question that Bernard has posed. Well, why did he do that? Why did he change what is natural to him and which could have brought him success?
Because I think, as we said earlier on, he knew that, like, Willie Casey's crew knew that he was going to come out and box, so I think he went out and said, right, I'll stand toe to toe with him and upset his game plan. But really what he done was he played into his strengths, because there's no way that he could ever stand toe to toe with Willie Casey, because he's just...
But that's my point, Jim, and I'm sorry to interrupt, but that's exactly what he did. But I'm just wondering,
I know, that's
why
what Bernard done
that
against Kiko Martinez as well. Ask him the same question. Well, like, the thing is, when fighters get in there, and sometimes with all good intentions and with all the training they have done, once the bell goes with the crowd behind you, the first dig, and then there's this macho thing that comes out on fighters, and you say, well, I'll show you and I'll stick with you, you know, and caution goes out the wind, and that's what happens.
You know, and the plan worked for two rounds for him, in fairness, but he just got tired and then got more tired, and Willie just got on top. Willie absorbed a lot of shot in the arms, the shoulders, and Paulie was just wasting energy.
Dara, it was, first of all, it was an absolutely amazing fight.
Indeed.
It lived up
yeah.
to all expectations. It's a long, long time since I've been glued to four rounds of fighting. Probably not since himself here was boxing. But it was a fascinating four rounds. And Hyland, it was a macho thing with him. I'm pretty sure of that. He reckoned, I'm going to surprise Willie Casey. I'm going to push him back. That was fairly obvious that was the plan. Mm. I'm going to take the play away from him. I'm going to push him back. He did push him back because he won the first two rounds, but the whole turning point came in round three when Willie Casey got on top and had a very, very good round, and we agreed here that was Casey's round. Willie then had the bit between his teeth. He felt this is it, piled the pressure on. Paulie is starting to tire. I thought for a moment he was trying to just absorb the punches, do a rope-a-dope Muhammad Ali on it and perhaps come back. But then when he stayed on the rope for too long, without coming back with punches, and the referee then had no option but to stand in to stop it.
Yeah.
I wouldn't say I'm shocked at it, but it was a. I'm surprised that it ended so quick in round four.
But Dara, you can train in the gym like 7 days a week, and you can perfect your boxing skills, but you can never train in the gym to become a brawler. You're either a brawler, you're either born that way.
As Willie Casey is.
As Willie Casey is.
Yeah.
Yeah, but that's because there's 23 kids in the
family.
Willie
Casey.
He has to brawl for his, for his breakfast, for his lunch, for his dinner. But he's a brawler.
No. Willie Casey would really take exception to that, and most certainly Phil Sutcliffe would too. No, that would be very unfair to Willie Casey. He's not a brawler. He's a box fighter. He has learned how to box as well as fight.
He's a brawler.
He's
a brawler.
He's far from a boxer.
He's a brawler who's trying to learn how to box.
He's got great leverage on that right hook.
He's learning his bit of boxing as well. Let's be fair.
But first and foremost, he's a brawler.
Yeah, okay.
A fighter.
Mm. Yeah.
we'll differ on that.
The right hook he threw today was great. He was trying to underneath to the body, but right up the middle, he was
worked well.
But even, I think Dave Boy said it in commentary, with his defence, he had, Paul Hyland's defence, he had one arm down at his waist.
We spoke about that prior to the fight, you know, when we were watching the highlights of Paulie's last fights. Mm. He cannot keep that left hand low, not against Willie Casey.
Yeah.
You just couldn't. You know, it's a guy who's coming and he's going to be aggressive. He's going to look to unload bombs. You know, early on, you cannot take those chances. I know. You just cannot take those chances because those type of guys, you know. But Willie, very clever, hands were up nice and tight, head movement was good and
movement,
anytime he got a chance to unload, he did, but and unloaded it in clusters.
Yeah, so impressive to watch. Not if you're Paul Hyland standing on the receiving end. This story, though, it's another chapter to it. 2 years, his 11th fight tonight, and he has the Championship of Europe, and now ranked in the top 15, I think it's WBA, is it, or C, but one of the major organisations, and this has just moved on to a new level
for
him.
Yeah, well, you know, it's absolutely amazing, because whether you went over to boxing, the prize fighter, this thing to have in England, where he's boxed over three rounds, three-minute rounds, I think that's what it is.
Three fights in one night.
And Willie came in as a substitute for Wayne McCullough, shocked everybody except his own camp, shocked everybody by winning it, and winning 25, 30 grand or something for himself as well. And that really gave him the momentum to pile forward. And here he is now, as you said, he's European champion, and a very, very deserving
in
one.
2 years.
But I tell you, in 2 years, but look what we have to look forward to. Kiko Martinez versus Willie Casey. That's going to be some matchup.
Our understanding, actually, now this we can be corrected on this, but we were told beforehand that title defence will happen sometime within a 90-day period. I know the lads were talking about another show in December, but within 90 days.
Yeah, the show in December is only four weeks away.
Yeah.
So Willie could get six or.
But the defence against Kiko,
that,
which has to happen, may happen within 90 days. Well, that's our information.
I don't know if the fight definitely has happened, but the fight has to be made and has to be signed. Okay. Within the 90 days.
Has to be agreed.
I think that fight will. I was making inquiries about that earlier on. I think that fight will happen sometime February or March.
Right. Okay.
Yeah.
Something to look forward to, isn't it?
Absolutely.
We'll talk more about that in due course, and we're going to look again at Willie Casey's amazing performance. This is a remarkable journey, only 2 years for the Limerick man, and he has the Championship of Europe, beating Paulie Hyland. Limerick has a new sporting hero, never mind boxing hero, Willie Casey. You've seen already from his interview and his talent, he's a real character, a fantastic boxer, and he is the European champion. We'll have more chat and we look in depth at his victory when we get back after the break. Don't move.
This Monday on Bad Fellas.
They couldn't believe just how much money you could make.
After the introduction of heroin to Ireland by the Dunn family, Irish society would never be the same again.
I think you'll have to view drugs as being the mainstay of organised crime.
Bad Fellas, Monday at 9:35 on RTE 1.
Saturday's all or nothing numbers are 2, 3, 5, 8, 9, 13, 16, 17, 20, 21, 22 and 23. You can check the results on lottery.ie and RTE Airtel page 152.
Finding car insurance at a price you like from a company you can trust is all about looking in the right place. So for real savings, check out Aviva today. If you've passed your driving test in the last 5 years, you could save an average of €220 just for passing ignition or 1 hour safe driving assessment. And for all our customers, there's a wide range of discounts available, including 20% off if you have no penalty points. Go to aviva.ie, call 1890 33 22 11 or contact your broker. Aviva, looking out for you.
Sure, no one's in.
Yeah. Hello, I'm Maeve from Aircom Phone Watch. Come on in. Say hello to Simon and Rachel, the owners.
Hiya.
Hello. When you tried to break in, you triggered the Aircom Phone Watch alarm. So when the signal was received, I of course contacted Simon and Rachel to make sure everything was all right. Unfortunately, Simon and Rachel were out when I contacted them. So I called the other key holders, their neighbour.
All right, lads.
And Rachel's brother, Brian. So that's about it. Oh, but I forgot to mention that after I contacted the key holders, I also called the guards.
Aircom Phone Watch, securing peace of mind.
Just stop that, please. It really. Yes, Orla, Renault has nailed its new scrappage deal. Because the leaders of car scrappage will now scrap all vans 5 years or older when traded in for a new Renault Kangoo, Trafic or Master. Europe's number one selling vans. And Renault is the first to mix in a 5-year warranty with unlimited mileage across its entire van range. Prices start at an amazing €8,990 ex-VAT. It really is van-ominal.
Fed up with fad diets? Ever wondered why they don't work for you? Do you want to lose weight, feel great, and look fabulous this Christmas? At Motivation Weight Management Clinics, we not only look at what you eat, but why you eat. Through private individual consultations, healthy eating plans, and behavior modification programs, we will help you to reach your ideal weight and, more importantly, to maintain it. So get yourself ready for the party season and call 1850 306000 or visit motivation.ie.
Grande cinnamon chai latte.
Tall skinny frappe latte.
A double mocha chocolate latte.
Decaf Americano with cream.
This is John.
Coffee, please.
Head of non-complication.
That's Mark.
No, no, not him. That's Mark. He's director of simplicity. Oh, and that's Laura. She's in charge of thinking ahead. So why am I telling you about these people? Well, I switched to eMobile, the new mobile phone service from Aircom, and now they work for me. Switch now, and they could work for you too. eMobile, it's for you.
They say it's what's underneath that counts. You just have to know where to look. Maybe you have to dig a little deeper, strip it back, smooth it out, get below the surface, filter it. They say it's what's underneath that counts. You just have to reveal it. Uniquely brewed Miller Genuine Draft. Cold filter to reveal the extraordinary.
Well, a popular winner in Limerick tonight, Willie Casey, the new European super bantamweight champion. He said before the fight that belt was not going to leave the city of Limerick, and it turned out to be the case for Casey. Not a lot of people a couple of weeks ago would have known about Willie Casey, but they do now. Very good. He's really going to enjoy this. And well, we can't say it's been a long time coming. Willie Casey is a man in a hurry. Just 2 years after turning pro, they said in his amateur days that his style wasn't necessarily suited to amateur boxing, but he's made the most of his talents and winning in such impressive style. Bernard, let's have a look at Willie in action in round two. And again, the power here, just frightening from Willie Casey.
You know, this is where Paul, he should have been using his jab and keeping Willie off and sticking it in his face nice and long. But no, Willie was able to just roll and bang whenever he wanted. You know, he got in close, and once he let that right hook go to the body, you know, he was causing damage when he was slowing Paulie down all the time. Paulie should never have been allowed him to get that close. Paulie's big long jab should have been sticking out every single time, right into Willie's face, shoving him back, keeping him off balance, and setting up shots for himself. But he didn't. He just abandoned his natural talent for being a technical fighter and, you know, became a brawler. For what reason, I've no idea. You know, maybe they thought they could upset Willie, but it didn't work.
But in the corner, would his corner man not be saying, hang on a second, we you know, can you not change that? It's clearly not working. You know, give him the instruction that perhaps he needed at that time.
I suppose they would never have expected it to go at that pace. Paulie tried to slow it down in the third, and especially in the fourth, tried to come right back, stay away, tried to slip a lot of shots. But it got to a stage where he just couldn't avoid Willie. Willie came in, he was hooking shots and, you know, just pinning him in on the ropes and just not, was unrelenting and just kept punching.
Jim?
Yeah, he was like a steam train tonight.
Yeah.
Just kept going forward, and the fight started off at a very, very, very fast pace. And then when Paulie tried to step off the gas to try and control the fight a bit more, Willie just kept on trucking, you know what I mean? And he kept going on, and I mean, he was, his style, that fight just suited him down to the ground. That pace suited him down to the ground. I mean, he loved it in there. He relished it in there, you know, and he came out victorious. And that's it.
Well, I'm sure the corner was saying to Paulie Hyland, yeah, keep it going, Paulie. You've won the first, you've won the second. Uh-huh. We had him marked up for those two rounds. But I was surprised at how quick he ran out of steam. Once that third round changed everything, Willie got on top, Willie took the round. And then from there on, it was just one-way traffic. I mean, Paulie seemed to just totally and absolutely
but
run out of gas.
But the punishment he was taking, Mick, was something else.
He was taking a lot around the ribs and so on, and Bernard made reference to that.
Do you think it could have been a weight problem, Mick?
I don't know. I mean, I always ask these questions of Hyland, and I ask them of Willie Casey, and they both tell you no. We make the weight easy enough.
Because Paulie Hyland is as tall as I am.
He is. He's 5'7". I know that. He's 5'7".
And I know how hard it is to make weight.
But he looks quite slim. He looks well as you. He's very, very similar to
you. He's younger than you, so it's easier to make the weight when you're younger.
Yeah, but Paulie's frame is very similar to Bernard Dunn's. Very, very similar. Height, shape, everything else. Willie Hyland built like a little tank. We said it earlier on. Jim Rock made the remark to me that Hyland looks so much more powerful Willie Casey, and he does. Mm. He does. He's got that little barrel chest and huge determination to win.
The Hyland tactics we have spoken about quite a lot since the end of the fight, and we saw Paul on the ropes quite a lot, Mick.
Yeah, I mean, I think here he was slipping, sliding, nice stuff, very, very good. Shoulders up nicely, he's moving the right hand. I like the way it's pinned up there. But he done too much of that. And then, as I said, when the steam started running out of him, Willie started getting to him with those big, big haymakers. A little bit of boxing, a little bit of fighting, and perhaps that little bit of brawling as well. Yeah. But it was very, very effective. He's just a massively strong bantamweight, and that's why super bantamweight. That's why I look forward with real keenness to when he takes on Kiko. Because both of them, very, very similar.
Same height,
height, same size, same power, and so on as well.
Paulie Hyland, like I said, he's only 25 years of age. Yeah. So he'll come again, you know. But it really was a man and a boy in there tonight.
It was. But Jim, I think that's a massive...
You can see the maturity in Willie Casey. Yeah. He's so strong, he's so determined. And I think, I don't know what he has. He's 25 kids or something like that. he's 4 or 5 kids or something like that.
Correct,
he's
fighting. Quickly, please.
He's fighting. Correct. You know, he's fighting for us. He's fighting for his family. He's fighting. I think he's a lot more to fight for at the moment than Hyland has. And Hyland will come again in a couple of years' time.
I think, in saying that, it's a massive, massive blow to Paulie Hyland. That will take a little bit of recovering from. That's going to take a number of easy fights to get him back into it. I agree that he's 25 and he's got time, but it is a massive, massive blow.
Look, Bernard, this was mentioned in the ring as well. You know, you know what this is all about. It's a crushing defeat. You're absolutely gutted on the night, but there is a route back for him, and you're the case in point.
There is, but you know, you have to give massive credit to Willie Casey here as well. You know, he was preparing him for a style of Kiko Martinez up until 2 weeks before this fight, and then all of a sudden you have to change to like, you know, polar opposite. A total boxer who's going to move. And that's what he was thinking he was going to face. But all of a sudden he was facing actually Kiko something
again.
Similar to Kiko, you know. And credit to Willie, you know, he changed styles there to try and fight Hyland instead of fighting Kiko. And, you know, then Hyland played straight into his hands and things worked out for him.
Well, you have to give an awful lot of credit to Phil Sutcliffe and that team, because they really worked things out very, very well. And it's all credit to them. Really worked it out very, very well, how to take on Hyland, how to push him back, which happened, as I said, in round three.
Paulie's got enough to be 2 down. You know, it's a defeat. It's not the end of the world.
No,
there are ways back. You know, there's plenty of shows being run in Dublin now and run in Ireland now at the moment. And, you know, he'll be active again, and it's just about, you know, walking your way back in. And, you know,
getting back on the bike again.
And it is.
And it's not his first defeat. It's a second defeat. And the thing is, it's a defeat for the European title. I mean, you know, it's a great title to get beaten for.
Yeah, sure.
I never fought for the European title, so I would have happily fought for it and got battered for it.
No, you wouldn't.
Just to have fought for it. Yes, I would have. Yeah. Yes, I would have.
Let's have a look at the end of the fight. Jim, you take this. Round four, and Willie just powering on.
Yeah, like Willie Casey, like I said, Nick said he's not a brawler. I'm saying he is. He's just in there, and he's loading up. I mean, all them punches, he's throwing them body and head. And, I mean, he knows he has his number there at the moment.
Good fighting, Willie.
It is. No, it's body and head, and you know, they're swinging shots. They're not real textbook shots, and I mean, he knows he's very tired there at the moment. Paulie's covering up, and he's just taking punishment, and the referee is just getting ready.
There is some sort of, you know, cleverness to it. You know, he's not just throwing head shots. You know, he's picking spots to throw them looking shots.
His body and head, but he's winging them in.
Yeah,
he's throwing them in. You know, like, they're not textbook shots.
That was a great body shot. Is that right hook to the body just knocked the stuffing out of Paulie? Really
as we said before, once you get hit with a body shot, now it will just take, like, that will take more out of you than headshots for 10 minutes.
They may not be textbook shots, but you did say that, Berlin, you're right. You know, he was thinking a little bit. He was banging in the body. He was coming up with the uppercut, landed very, very well. He was swinging both lefts and rights around the head. So, you know, there was a bit of thought put into what he was doing. He wasn't just milling everything and anything in front of him. He was hitting the body. He was getting around the back of the elbow. Then he'd come right up the middle as well.
Crack and shrug.
Yeah, some really good scores.
Right uppercut he had.
Me saying he's a brawler, I mean, people love that. The crowd love that.
Well, the crowd here loved it tonight.
Love a fight like that. That yeah. He is just going to bring excitement.
He will, of course.
And people are just going to want to see him fight. Yeah. And when he fights Keegan Martinez, I mean, I'd say... Well, I don't know if there's a phone box down here big enough for them to fight in, but I'm sure that's what it could be for.
And the one thing you take from there as well, you see Paul at the end, he didn't seem to complain too much about the stoppage, so, you know, it was a good decision.
And he never went down,
yeah.
Which again is another plus for him, you know?
Yeah. Kiko Martinez, Bernard, your old buddy. And they're both very similar, but, you know, the style, they're the same height, as we said, both 5 foot five. How Willie is relishing this. You know about this guy.
I remember Mr. Martinez very, very well. Not so much from that fight, but from, I suppose, you know, revisiting it, you know, writing my book, which is, you know, I've just finished. You know, he's a class, you know, act when he gets into the zone and lets them shots go. What impressed me about him on this show was he actually stepped back, used his jab on occasions. You know, and he wasn't just going the hole, which I've seen him. It's against Monroe, he was like, you know, really a headless chicken, just swinging shots. Whereas here he was more calculated in his movement, and he was stepping in and stepping out with his punches. It's going to make for a great fight. And, I think it's a toss-up. You know, it's a 50-50. Willie's going to relish getting into the ring with that man. And I think he's, you know, listened to him in the ring there. You know, he's willing to fight a couple of guys before he fights him. You know, that's Willie all over. You know, I watched him last Saturday on TV when he was on the Brendan O'Connor show, and he was brilliant.
He's a great character.
You know, he's refreshing. Yeah. He really is refreshing to the sport. And, you know, he's a happy-go-lucky fella, you know, and he's in it for fun.
Well, you know, he's beaten Paulie Hyland, but Kiko Martinez will be a different, totally different proposition. As we said, same height, real, real power with Martinez. He surprised me in that last fight, Bernard, as we've mentioned earlier on. The boxing skill that he showed us, he showed me something that I didn't think he had. I thought when he beat Bernard here that all he had was just power. Yeah. I got one lucky shot or two or three lucky shots.
Yeah, especially when you see him against Monroe, he didn't really show anything.
He did not.
He showed the movement there in that last fight.
But in that fight when he won the title, he showed really good skill, boxing very, very well. Mm-hmm. He knew he wasn't going to put his man away in that first round or second round. What did he do? He changed into a different gear, started thinking and started boxing and done so very, very well.
Yeah, so for you, Jim, is he a better boxer than he has been over the last couple of years, Kiko Martinez?
Well, Kiko Martinez is learning, you know, and he's perfecting. Like, he's in the gym and he's training all the time and he's perfecting his boxing skills, obviously. I mean, from the start of his career, he was knocking everybody out. Then he suddenly realised, hey, I know how to fight. I have that natural ability.
Yeah.
Now I'm going to learn, and I'm going to learn to put the punches together, put my combinations together.
I'm just wondering how will, because Willie Casey, we've seen him all night, and we watched it in the four and a bit rounds that we saw, that he wants to go forward, he wants to be aggressive, he's got this fantastic power. How he's going to do the same, obviously, with Kiko Martinez, but that is part of his approach too. It's going to be a cracking fight.
It's going to be like two colossal forces, you know,
behind
colliding.
Behind the couch at home.
Yeah. It'll be very, but sometimes, like, and we've seen down through the years, that sometimes when you think a fight is going to be as good as that, it can turn out to be a terrible fight.
Styles clash and so on,
and it can happen so easily. And we don't want them, both of them, coming too close and tying each other up. And then we're not getting.
Then it becomes negative.
Then we're not getting to see the punches
Willie's
go off.
Going to take so much from this victory. You know, being European champion does something.
Talk to me about that. Well, what does it do to you?
It just, you know, it gives you such a lift. It really does. It makes you feel, you know, well, he has achieved something. He's European champion, and, you know, there's millions of fighters that would give the right arm just to even get in the ring, as Jim said, just to fight for the belt, never mind hold it. And whether it be for one day or 10 years, he can tell his grandkids he's European champion. You know, and he will get such a lift from him, and everybody talking to him, and everybody, you know, who watched the fight tonight will know who he was. Everyone here tonight will definitely remember him. Because he's such an energetic fighter, and was fantastic. But he will learn to box a little bit better, I think. Phil Sukkoth will work on this kid now over the next few months, gearing up towards Kiko. Everything they do from here on in will be Kiko orientated. Every single thing they do. So he will be well prepared.
Well, you know, Joe Forbes, that works with Kiko Martinez there as his interpreter and his advisor and so on, he reminded me again tonight, and we said this on a previous program, he said he will take both boys on the same night. Now he doesn't have to worry about Paulie Hyland, but he certainly will have to worry about Willie Casey.
Yeah.
That's for sure.
Jim?
But also, they say when you win a title like that, it increases your boxing ability. It increases your game by about
30%.
Really? Determination. It increases your determination. Because what you're willing to sacrifice. It really
will,
does.
And it will also, like, it makes you more believe in yourself more. you know, and you'll train that little bit harder in the gym, because in your mind, well, I'm European champion.
And when he does step into the ring on that night, he'll have that belt around his waist. He has it, and Martinez has got to take it off him, and that's a different mindset
I think it's the pressure of, you know, I'm champion, and every single guy below me is trying to pull me down.
Yes.
You know, and it's known that, you know, the sport's on, you know, and it's...
And sometimes it can work the other way, that sometimes they say the fighter fighting for the title puts everything in, and once he gets it, sometimes they don't train as hard for it because they're the champion then.
Well, it's fairly obvious now, Jim, that this championship, this European title fight will go on here in Limerick. It's Casey versus Martinez here in Limerick, and that's going to be worth a round or two or three to Willie Casey here with, I mean, a massive support he got here tonight.
Yeah, how much was that worth to him? Because the place has been fizzing all day, and I know watching at home, the atmosphere had to jump out of the TV at you. It's really electric all night.
Well, I think it helps, even though we say, you know, look, it doesn't matter. We saw Poonswat coming over here to Ireland and taking Bernard out of it as well. But, you know, when the bell goes, there's only two of you in there at the same time. Willie Casey has been saying that. Hyland had been saying that. It didn't matter. Mm. You know, but I think it's like a home match in football or hurling as well. It is a bit of a psychological advantage to you.
It's moments when you're
tired.
Yeah. You know, it's moments when you're tired and somebody else on top that you hear that voice shouting at you, screaming at you, you hear the clapping, you hear the thumping of feet. You know, it gets you going again. You know, it gives you that little bit of extra energy.
Brilliant stuff, guys. Great. Well, we enjoyed watching Willie Casey in action this evening, the new European super bantamweight champion. We'll talk more about Willie when we come back. Far side of the break, though, we're going to have a look at some of the action on the undercard here in Limerick this evening. A couple of really good fights for you. Don't go away.
To get Ireland flirting and dating like never before.
Irish girls are tough. Irish girls are fun.
My type of guy is funny.
Ha. A new series, One Night Stand, starts Thursday at 10 on RTE2.
When heartburn rages like fire, you need Rennie Dual Action. Dual power to combat heartburn.
To learn anything you don't already know, or do anything you don't already do. All you have to do is be you. You are the controller.
Everybody keeps on listening in. Nobody's listening.
Introducing Kinect for Xbox 360.
Hi, we're here to view the house.
Oh, come in.
This is the bedroom.
Through here is the kitchen.
And this is the living room.
Yes, nice. Even if it is a bit red. Do you have a BER?
BER?
A building energy rating certificate. By law, anyone selling or renting a property has to supply one. Like this. It shows the energy performance of a house on a scale from A1 to G. Green is the most energy efficient and red is the least.
No.
Right, we'll be in touch.
Before you buy or rent a property, ask to see the BER certificate. It's your right.
In that last 15 minutes, this is where games are won and lost. The body's fatigued, it's painful. The intensity changes, things become hurried. It's time the game where you can score important goals and become a hero if you like. I drink Lucozade Sport because it gets to work fast, keeps me hydrated. You want to win and still have that inner belief that you can do it. You need to dig deep and go where it hurts to try and pull a bit of magic out.
Lucozade Sport. Last longer, finish stronger in the last 15 minutes.
It's that time of year again. Time to start collecting your SuperValue Real Reward points towards a fresh Irish turkey at half price. And don't forget, you'll also be collecting Real Reward points towards 5% off your big Christmas shop. That's value the SuperValue way.
instant hydration with the new Wilkinson Sword Hydro. Water-activated gel hydrates your skin as you shave, and five blades with skin guards help reduce irritation. Our best shave for your skin. New Hydro from Wilkinson Sword. Free your skin.
Now at Toyota, every new car registered before January 31st comes with 3 years free servicing, including the new Toyota Corolla from just €16,635 with scrappage. That's called an even better deal. Talk to your Toyota dealer now.
This year, be careful who you let in.
Do you think there's such a thing as evil?
Let me in.
Now, lots more sport coming your way here on RTE, with rugby topping the bill. Samoa are in Ireland at the moment. They take on Connacht next Tuesday. It's live on RTE 2 and RTE Online from 7. And Ireland meet the Samoans in an international at the weekend. That game, along with France versus Fiji, live across all RTE platforms from 2 o'clock on Saturday afternoon. Premier Soccer Saturday in its usual slot later that evening. Villa, Manchester United, Manchester City, Spurs and Liverpool. Just some of the teams featured there. That is at 8 on RTE2. And a reminder of our next Pro Box Live. That's a fortnight from now. On Saturday, November the 20th, Andy Murray headlines as he takes on the world number 14, Claudine Lacerda of Brazil. Now, this is Willie Casey's dressing room. Paul Hyland in there to congratulate the new European champion. Some nice shots there. Friends at the end of it all, but Willie Casey, the champion of Europe, and Paul Hyland wishing Casey and his team all the best for the future. Now, let's show you some action from the undercard here at the University of Limerick. Martin Rogan made his return to the ring tonight. He's been out for over a year with a bad neck injury, but back fully fit and back in action. And he was fighting here this evening against Yavor Marinchev. Let's show you the best of that. This is at heavyweight.
Second count, round one.
Well, the Iron Man returns to the ring. Martin Rogan back inside the ropes a year to the day since his last fight against Sam Sexton at the Odyssey Arena in Belfast. He's back after recovering from a neck injury which threatened his career. Boy, is he back. Beginning to start here, really on the front foot. And already, Marinchev from Bulgaria has been bottled up in the corner. Martin Rogan, really a man on a mission here tonight. Six rounds, his heavyweight contest is scheduled to go. But as I say, looks like Rogan wants to get an early night here. Rogan in the gold shorts, known as Iron Man after that neck injury. He had a titanium plate inserted in his neck. A man made of Belfast steel now. Plenty of steel and resolve. Marinchev already knows he's going to be in for a very busy evening here, Dave.
Yeah, those are really good, solid body shots that Rogan's throwing in. A real good tight ones, and you can tell there, Marinchev, he grabbed on there, he moved in and grabbed on to Rogan, you know, to stop him, you know, from throwing more body shots there. But you can tell that there's a bit of power there, and he's hurting Marinchev at this early stage of the fight.
Well, Rogan, he's such a great character.
Don't do that shit.
Belfast boy.
Let's go.
Warning there from referee Emil Teat for Yaron Marinchev. Back down to the ropes.
Put
once
your
again.
Head. Put your head.
Rogan, of course, who shot to fame by winning the Prize Fighter Series.
Watch your head. Let's go. Box.
Paving the way, I suppose, really, for the likes of Willie Casey to follow suit. And then, of course, was the famous duel with Audie Harrison, causing a massive upset back in 2008. And then became Commonwealth champion with a victory over Matt Skelton.
Stop!
That injury clearly a setback to his
box.
Blossoming
box.
Career.
Box.
He's now 39 years of age. The time not exactly on his side, but he's determined to go as far as he can in the game.
See, the referee says to Marinchev, look, you're going to box, because he's not trying here. He's being hurt, you know, Rogan's throwing some good solid shots, but what Rogan wants to do here, the fact that he hasn't been in the ring in nearly a year, he wants to take his time here, try and get some rounds under his belt, because he's fighting next month.
Run, let him go.
He wants to try and get some rounds under his belt here. Oh, that's a good cracking left hook to the body there.
And he may not get too many more rounds under his belt here because Marinchev is taking a count here from referee Emil Tiet.
7, 8.
Well, there may be an element of rustiness, but Marinchev is struggling to get back to his feet, and he won't make it, and he hasn't made it. And it's a victory in the first round here. What a return from Martin Rogan, the Iron Man, doing the business here in Limerick tonight. He has a big travelling support with him, and he has done the business in some style inside the opening round here. Marinchev down to the deck, clearly winded and the worse for wear. And Rogan, well, what a return to the ring.
Well, Martin Rogan, another great character in Irish boxing. And Mick, fantastic to see him back in the ring. We'd like to have seen him in there a bit longer, but hey, he can only beat the guy who's standing in front of him.
Yeah, great to see him back. You know, after all he's gone through, they call him the Iron Man because he's had so many nuts and bolts and plates put into his neck from a serious injury he had. But good to see him back. He needed that badly because, as we said there, he's going to fight in about 2 weeks' time again, actually, over at Castlebar. But the punch that finished it there was a very, very good left hook to the right to the solar plexus. Good shot, and I watched and looked with interest when I heard him ask, the referee asked, did he want to box or did he not, you know, because sometimes you get these guys to come over here and all they want to just do is get the payday.
Yeah.
But to be fair to him, you would have to say that the punch he went down with was a good shot to the body.
Yeah, Jim, good to see Martin back.
It's great to see him back. You know, he is a character. He's a big character up there in Belfast, and I have to say, like, he trained in our gym up there in Belfast for a couple of years, and the crack in the gym was unbelievable when he was there. Now, sometimes it wasn't really good because we'd be all laughing so much, we weren't doing enough training with the stories Rogie be coming out with. But look, he's terrific. Again, similar type of story to Willie Casey here tonight. Went over, won the prize fighter.
Yeah.
Then he beat the European champion, Martin Rogan did, but the European title wasn't on the line that time. So quite similar tales for him and Casey. But he's very good, he's very exciting, and you know, I say he's a man in a hurry at the moment. Now he's going to fight 2 weeks time in Castlebar,
yeah,
and then hopefully he'll fight for some sort of Commonwealth Championship or something next year again.
Yeah, Bernard, another sensational story in many ways. This neck injury has a titanium plate inserted in the back of his neck somewhere.
Yeah.
But you know, to see him back in there, fab.
Yeah, it was great. You know, you could see a bit of ring rust there, you know, being out of the ring for so long. You try to impress, and you know, you're throwing shots from angles and distances that you shouldn't be throwing them from, you know. But you know, Martin again is, you know, as Jim was saying, another example of, you know, rags to riches. You know, he came from relatively unknown and all of a sudden exploded onto the scene when he won prize fighter, and has built up a legion of fans. You know, I spoke to him at the Paul McCluskey show, the last one up in Letterkenny. And he said he's a man. He is a man in a hurry. He said he wants to get as active and as quickly to a championship fight as possible.
All right. Well, let's hope that's in the not too distant future for Martin Rogan. We'll see him in action in Brafey House in Castlebar in a couple of weeks' time in our next Pro Box Live. Earlier on this evening, it was our first live fight. Seems like a long time ago now. We saw Luis Garcia, who's from Cuba. You know, he's based in Cork and was so impressive here this evening. But his stablemate and his training companion is Mike Perez, also from Cuba, also training in Cork. And he was in action tonight against Pavel Dolgoffs. And let's see the best of that now. This at heavyweight, scheduled for 6 rounds. Adrian Eames with commentary again.
Well, this has the makings of a cracking contest between Mike Perez and Pavel Dolgoffs. Dolgoffs hails from Latvia, but Perez, based in Cork, and very impressive so far in his young career, just 25 years of age. The Cuban southpaw, 11 straight wins, 9 by way of knockout. A real shooting star on the heavyweight scene. That's the view of promoter Brian Peters, who's been talking big about this guy. Weighed in yesterday, bang on 17 stones. Dolgoffs, by contrast, 16 stone, 12 pounds and 6 ounces. Heavyweight contest scheduled to go 6 rounds here. He's certainly embraced to life on Lee side, as Mike Perez. That's a Cuban crew based down in Cork. Fittingly, he's known as the Rebel.
What? Don't know what happened there.
Well,
I think we're seeing an uppercut of some sort, but I don't see where it landed. And
Dolgov's already in trouble here in the opening round here. And a shake of the head. And he's clearly feeling the effects. Emil Tiet, the referee, he's making sure, having the count. And Dolgov's now has to try and stand firm here as Perez closes in. to finish this one inside the first round here. Very quick hands from Perez.
I can tell you, like, Perez looks very fat around the middle and very. I've watched him, I've commented.
And there goes Golgov. Hits the canvas for the second time in the opening round here. And Dolgov is out on his feet. Emil Tiet says it's all over here.
On safety, the referee has stopped the contest.
Leaving the winner. Is the winner and inside the first round here. Pavel Dolgov, well beaten twice on the canvas here. But Perez chalks up his 12th win in 12 outings here at UL.
Well, a very powerful shot from Perez. Bernard Dunn, how good is Mike Perez potentially?
Again, you know, like Garcia, you know, and Brian, he must be wetting his lips with the talent that he has in his hands. You know, I suppose his problem is going to try to sell them here and try to market them here, you know. You could build the records here and then probably get them to America where they will be, I suppose, bigger phenomenons. But amazing talent, the speed of him for a heavyweight guy, you know. He does look like he's put on a few pounds now, in fairness, since the last time I seen him. So maybe he needs to be a little bit more active in the gym.
I heard Adrian say 17 stones on the hoof, yeah, as somebody once said.
Yeah, Perez is a really good fighter, Dara. You know, we've seen him here. The last time we saw him here, he won two fights in the one night, actually, you know.
That's right, yeah.
Stopping both opponents. Very, very good. But he's the kind of fighter, too, that can blow hot and cold. I've seen him being very, very poor at the National Stadium, going back, I suppose, a year and a half ago now, and they put him on ice for a little while before he got serious again about it. But certainly, when he takes it serious, puts his mind to it, he's a very, very good fighter.
Jim?
Yeah, I think he's just back from an injury. I think he got an insect bite when he's away on holidays or something like
Spotted
that.
Spotted fever, I think.
Spotted
I read.
Spotted fever, yeah. So maybe, you know, and he wasn't able to train for that, so maybe while he wasn't training, he was eating too many Mars bars and that, because he does look pudgy around the midsection compared to what he was and what he has been. So hopefully we'll see that go, because he really did look very chiselled before, and he's a bit more rounded now.
Spotted fever.
But look, they're young
bars.
Guys. Yeah, I know. Remember how young, like, they're very young men. Like, you know, they've got so much time to develop. It's
and the hand speed he has, is, like, he would remind me of a very young Mike Tyson. You look videos of Mike Tyson years ago, the speed he had and the action he had, and he has that. He has the speed and he has every punch in the book, uppercuts, hooks, body and head, like. Terrific, terrific array of punches.
Well, the fact is, he's a southpaw as well, I suppose, helps him along. And you will have noticed Nicholas Cruz there doing his corner.
Yeah.
And Nicholas is very... He really has great plans for these three fighters. They're very, very good. The little bantamweight, super bantam, is really an excellent fighter also.
But as well, all these fighters, every one of them, no matter tonight, every one of them are getting their opportunity because of Brian Peters. Mm. And I mean, I suppose we have to give him a mention, because what he's doing, like... This is the fourth European title fight in Ireland here within the last 9 or 10 weeks. Mm. I mean, it's unheard of. Now, no matter how good a fighter is, if you haven't got a promoter who is willing to showcase you, no one will know about you. Mm. You know, so he's giving all these fighters their opportunity, and he's pulling all the strings, and he's getting them all the fights. Like, a big round of applause.
Well, I
really
suppose it's
briefly,
true.
Mick,
yeah. Yeah, it's just through the connections of Brian that the Kiko Martinez vacated that title so easily, so quickly, because Brian guaranteed him that he would get a shot at it, because Brian does have a stake now in Kiko Martinez.
All right, and that's something to look forward to. Really is something to look forward to, isn't it, for the not-too-distant future. Just before we go, let's round up some of the other action on the undercard here at the University of Limerick. First of all, Brendan Fitzpatrick was in action. This was earlier on. Sionko was his opponent at super middleweight, scheduled for 6 rounds. Brendan Fitzpatrick was the winner, and this was for the Irish super middleweight title. Anthony Fitzgerald and Lee Murta. This was ruled a new contest because of that, a clash of heads, and Lee Murta ended up with a terrible cut early in the contest, and some work on him a little later with the needle and thread, Lee Murta, after a terrible collision. And that's Alan Donlan, young man from Galway, fighting here this evening, winning at light middleweight. Okay, men, just before we go, our closing thoughts. We've seen the emergence of a new star about a week ago, 10 days ago. Not too many people, Bernard Dunn, would have known about Willie Casey. Now they do.
Now they do, and now it's time. It's Willie's time to shine. He stepped out of the shadows into the limelight. Next step is Kiko Martinez, and he needs to, you know, stay focused on that and not get distracted now by his newfound fame of being European champion.
I think he'll be okay. He seems to be coping
it all
right.
Yeah, he strikes me as that type of person who can handle no problem.
Yeah. Mick?
Yeah, let him worry about Kiko Martinez for now. You know, there's world titles and so on out there as well, but I think that's much, much further down the road for Willie Casey. He's got to get over Kiko Martinez first.
Jim, yeah, final word
I
to
think
you.
Before even Kiko Martinez, he said he's going to have either one or two fights. So, I mean, he's got to stay focused for them, because the last thing he wants is to go out and take what he thinks is an easy fight, not go in there prepared and get beaten by somebody that shouldn't beat him.
Well, when Bernard Dunne won that belt 4 years ago, was a stepping stone to great things, ultimately to the world title. It would be nice to think for Willie Casey that might be something in his future, but he's got Kiko Martinez on the horizon for him. That's going to be a fight to look forward to. We've had a brilliant night here in Limerick. My thanks to Mick, to Bernard and to Jim for your company as always, and thanks to you for watching. Willie Casey, the champion of Europe from Limerick, good night.
Fourth member of
this is my father, Mike.
Cheers.
I can't believe I'm